Christy. I'm Bailey.
I'm Allie.
And I'm Kirsten.
And we're here with your current events for Friday, May 3rd.
ESC dates have been determined. Tuesday, May 7th will be the U.S. History. Monday, May 13th will be Biology. Tuesday, May 14th will be Algebra 2. And Wednesday, May 15th will be English 2.
Attention seniors. Senior picnic is scheduled for Friday, May 17th from 10 to 2. And senior breakfast is scheduled for Tuesday, May 21st at 8:45. Be sure to stop by Student Services to pick up your tickets for these events.
Senior slideshow pictures are due by today to Student Services. You can submit a maximum of 5 photos and they must be printed. If you want them returned, please write your name on the back of each picture.
Fellowship of Christian Athletes will host a joint baccalaureate for members of the graduating class of 2013 from Apollo, Daviess County, and Owensboro High Schools. Service begins at 7 p.m. Monday, May 13th at Bellevue Baptist Church and is open to the public. Everyone is welcome.
Student Council's annual May Day 5K will be held May 18th, 2013. It is $15 to pre-register until May 10th and will be $20 after that. If you pre-register, you are guaranteed an awesome shirt. Forms are available in Student Services and all proceeds will be donated to CareNet.
Attention Key Club members, all hours are due today. Congratulations to the new Key Club officers, Jack Martin, President, Allie Ramore, Vice President and Volunteer Coordinator, David Hayden, Secretary, and Katie Peoples, Treasurer.
Yearbook is selling friendship ads for $10. Stop by to purchase your ad during lunch. Hurry because space is limited.
Attention JCL members, we will be bowling today at Diamond Lane South. The cost is $7. Sign up with Ms. Chafisi in room 201. All members are invited. Also, officer applications are available with Ms. Chafisi, and the spring banquet is May 14th.
Congratulations to the following orchestra students who performed at the KMEA Solo and Ensemble Festival on Saturday. Proficient ratings, Matija Young, Jacinta Young, Jordan Roberts, Tyler Henderson, Lexi Lindsay, Matthew Millay, Brenna Morshiga, Claire Haller. Distinguished ratings, Samantha Howard, Lacey McDonald, Adriana Bowman, Rebecca Addington, Brianna Cornett, Peyton Sharp, Nadia Hamilton, Emily Miller, Wilbur Galvez, Isaac Taylor, Tyler Belcher, Malcolm Campbell, Christopher Barrera, Catherine Settle, Taryn Pierce, Amber Bryant, Travis Welsh, Claire Payne, and Landon Case.
The DCHS academic team competed in the Knowledge Master Open on Tuesday, April 23rd in two divisions, high school and ninth grade only. The ninth grade team, consisting of Evan Clark, Seth Marksberry, Hirsch Mulani, Sonal Muthalali, Catherine Rowe, and Eric Schwinder, came in first in the state and 19th out of the 72 competing teams from 5 countries. The varsity team, consisting of Ella Shipp, Douglas Rowe, Sarah Warren, Kaylin Kufal, Ryan Perk, Dylan Childers, Evan Clark, and Seth Marksberry also came in first in the state. They were 34th out of the 496 teams from 5 countries, so DCHS has 2 more state championships.
Woo! This past weekend, members of the DCHS academic team participated in the National History Bowling Bee and in the U.S. Geography Olympiad in Washington, D.C. The History Bowl team of Evan Clark, Douglas Rowe, Ella Shipp, Dylan Childers, and Sarah Warren finished 49th out of 132 teams. In the History Bee, Ella Shipp qualified for the national quarterfinals by placing 16th out of 175 students. And in the U.S. Geography Olympiad, Ella Shipp placed 15th in the Varsity Quiz Bowl portion, while Evan Clark placed 20th in the JV Quiz Bowl and 5th in the written exam section. Congratulations to all the students who participated in this prestigious event.
Attention seniors! Graduation DVD, senior slideshow DVDs, and senior night DVDs will be on sale during lunch or in Student Services next week. The graduation DVDs are $15, senior slideshow DVDs are $10, and senior night DVDs are $5. The DVDs may be picked up the week of June 24th through the 28th from 8 to 3 in the front office.
AP Lit students, there will be 4 after-school review sessions before the May 9th exam. Sunday, May 5th at Panera at 4 o'clock, Monday, May 6th in room 134 at 3:30, Tuesday, May 7th in room 136 at 3:30, and Wednesday, May 8th in room 134 at 3:30. Please try to attend at least one.
AP Lang students, stop by Dr. Gunner's room to pick up study materials for the AP exam. Study sessions will be Tuesday, May 7th at 7:15 a.m. and at 3:15 p.m. in Dr. Gunner's room.
Attention Beta Club members, intent to run forms must be turned in by Wednesday, May 8th.
Cole Hamilton was elected the FFA Green River Region Vice President out of 10 schools in our region. Congrats, Cole.
The annual FFA banquet will be held. The annual FFA banquet will be held on Thursday, May 9th at 6 p.m. in the DCHS cafeteria. Tickets are on sale for $5. See Mr. Askins, Mr. Howard, or Mr. Smith to purchase your tickets or for more information.
That's the end of current events for today.
Thanks for watching us.
See ya. Bye.
Good afternoon, D.C. I'm Katie Bouchard.
And I'm Shannon McLemore.
And these are your sports for May 3rd. This past weekend, the baseball team traveled to Louisville for the Louisville Invitational Tournament. The Panthers came home with three wins at the Louisville Tournament. The Panthers earned a 3-2 win over Danville in the first game and a 6-3 win against Fern Creek in the second game.
Sean Pedley went the distance against Danville, striking out two and allowing five runs. Walker Owens and Jed Aaron drove in a run while Pedley doubled. Owens went 2-4 with three RBIs, and Pedley went 2-3 with two RBIs against Fern Creek. Zach Burton went four innings, only allowing three hits and two earned runs, getting the win against Fern Creek.
Kyle Schneider pitched his second straight no-hitter in an 8-0 win against Louisville Southern. Schneider struck out 15, hit a home run, and a triple. The Panthers beat Catholic Tuesday night in a 4-3 come-from-behind win. Nathan Heap picked up the win in relief. Good luck to the Panthers baseball team as they will compete in the Christian County Tournament. Now stay tuned for a short interview with Brandon Blake about his recent trip to South Carolina playing in a major golf event. Hey DC, I'm here with Brandon Blake talking to him about his wonderful golf experience that he traveled to this past weekend in South Carolina. Tell us how you got invited to this tournament.
They chose 32 from the eastern part of the United States to play with the top 54 juniors in the world. I got to play with a kid from Germany, which was pretty cool. Got to talk to him about a lot of cool stuff.
Tell us a little bit about the experience.
We got there Wednesday. I got to meet with Jack Nicklaus, which was cool because he's one of the best golfers to ever play the game. Then we played Thursday in the tournament, which was cool. Like I said, I played the kid from Germany. The golf course was amazing. We got our own caddies.
I heard that there was a lot of sponsors there at the tournament. Did you get anything from those sponsors?
Yes, Nike Golf was on site with their tour van, and they gave us $300 worth of free clothes and golf equipment, and Golf Pride gave us about $80 worth in golf grips.
Are you planning to play golf in college?
Yes, I'd like to. I'd really like to play golf in college.
Do you have any top picks that you're looking into?
I'd like to go down south, maybe in like the South Carolina area or Florida area. So.
Okay, thank you, Brandon.
Daniel Southard covered the 3,200 meters with the school record 9 minutes and 15 seconds to place 9th in the Eastern Relay. John Capps placed 10th in high jump with the jump of 6 feet, and Ben Capps came in 10th in the steeplechase.
Congratulations to the Panthers track team for winning the City County Track and Field Championship this past Tuesday night. The Lady Panthers track finished 3rd in the City County Championship on Tuesday night.
On Tuesday night, the girls softball team played against Hancock County and won 4-0. Madeline Bowles was 2-4 with the triple, and Caitlin Armstrong limited Hancock County to one hit. On Wednesday night, the Lady Panthers softball team defeated Heritage Hills 13-5. Madeline Bishop went 3-4 with the RBI and two-run score. Caitlin Armstrong went 2-3 with two RBIs. Good luck to the Lady Panthers as they will be competing in the Lexington Lafayette.
Congratulations to Laura Ross, who will be signing with Asbury College on Tuesday, May 14th in the Media Center to continue her tennis career. Good luck in the future. That's all we have, DC. See you next week. This week on Student Life, we're going around asking students how to spell words.
Spell February.
F-E-B-R-U-A-R-Y.
Oh, good job. We spell khaki.
K-H-A-K-I?
Yeah. we spell kaleidoscope?
No.
Why?
I don't want to. No, I'm not going to embarrass myself. No.
Spell kindergarten.
What?
It's not even that hard.
I don't want to spell. I hate spelling.
Will you spell kindergarten?
Okay. K-I-N-D-E-R-G-A-R-D-T-D-T.
Will you spell kaleidoscope?
Sure. K. I don't know how to spell it.
Will you spell break for me?
B-R-E-A-K or B-R-A-K-E?
Can you spell cereal?
C-E-R-E-A-L.
No, S-E-R-I-A-L. Can you spell leprechaun?
What?
How do you spell leprechaun?
L.
What's that?
D.
It's all you,
sir.
P.
P.
R? No.
Lepra.
R-O.
I have no idea. C-O-N.
C-O-N, maybe. C-O-N.
R-O.
Leprechaun.
I
don't know.
I was kidding.
Say it.
I don't know. L. E P A lepra A C O N.
How do you spell it, Miss Kilburn?
Leprechaun. L I T T L E G R E E N M A N. Leprechaun.
Oh yeah, sales on. Yo, macaron, yeah, macaron, no, chacaron, 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 chacaron.
Oh man, I gotta go. Can you watch my stuff real quick?
Yeah, I'll watch your stuff.
Why are you saying it like that?
I mean, I'll watch your stuff.
Alright, I'll be back. Hey, thanks for watching my stuff, man.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, I'm back.
Thanks.
Wait, what did you do to it?
Nothing happened.
Okay.
Why are you so sweaty?
I'm tired.
You're tired?
I mean, it's just hot in here. It's
good. It's fine.
Did you get the codes? It was you the whole time?
You can do it, Nick!
You're really pretty, you know that? El do nutto. And then this donut said the other donut, I'm gonna eat you!